गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, गुड मॉर्निंग,
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम,
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम,
ओके गुड मॉर्निंग. सो
आई एम नॉट एबल टू प्रिंट आउट दैट नाउ.
एंड नो प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन ओपन योर मोबाइल नो नाउ.
मैम आई आल्सो आई वाज नॉट एबल टू प्रिंट आउट.
हां ओके ओके ओके, ओपन योर मोबाइल. हां ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दोस लिटिल मैथ मैजिक प्रॉब्लम्स. दीस क्वेश्चंस आर published by CBSE. These are some little bit applicable, application level and challenging questions also, that you have already studied. The basic theory you have already studied, but you have to think in a different way to solve these questions. You are going to apply the things you have already studied. Okay children,
okay ma'am.
Shall we start?
Yes ma'am.
Okay. Okay, the first unit is unit 9, time and again. Then I will show the board so that you can read it. One second. Can you read it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In her chemistry lab class, Reena heated a liquid until it boiled. After a while, she measured the temperature of the liquid as it cooled down. The following table shows its temperature in degree Celsius. C means degree Celsius and T minutes after it boiled. So what she did, she in her lab, she boiled a liquid. After boiling, she put off that stove. Then she allows to cool. While it is cooling, she is noting the temperature of the liquid. Okay, and she she prepared a table shows what was the decrease in temperature while cooling. Understood? What she is doing? She allowed to boil that liquid. After that, switch off the stove or burner, she allows to cool that liquid. And within some intervals of time, she is noting the temperature of the liquid. And she noted that in a form of a table. So, time in minutes and temperature in degree Celsius, and zero means it boils. The time when it boils, it starts from boiling. When it boils, she's put on the stove or burner. Okay, after 4 minutes, temperature is 96.04, 8 minutes, 87.08. 12 minutes 78.12, and 16 minutes it is 69.16. After 20 minutes it is 60.2. And Reena believes that the relation between C and T is modeled by a linear equation. Linear equation we have studied. A linear equation means 2x plus y. Linear equation, 2x plus y, degree. X square won't be there, y square won't be there. Degree of the variable will be one. Such equations are known as linear equations. We have studied linear equation in one variable, isn't it? No. Okay. And the teacher observed Reena and was impressed with her work and efforts. To test Reena on the basis of her understanding and thoroughness of her work, the teacher asked the following questions. First question. In your opinion, what are the independent and dependent variables in the scenario? Here the equation is C. Here the equation is C equal to negative 2.24t plus 105. 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to this. This is the equation. C equal to, this is the linear equation. Okay. power of C and power of T. Variables are C and T. Like X and Y, variables are C and T. C equal to negative 2.24T plus 105. And the first question is, which is the dependent variable and independent variable? I have explained this dependency and independency with an example of electricity and consumption of electricity and electricity bill. Do you remember that example? When the use of consumption increases, electricity bill increases. Do you remember that example? I explained when consumption of electricity increases, the yes, electricity sir. Bill increases. Do you remember that example? Huh? Children, do you remember that?
No.
No?
Yes, sir.
Dependent yes, sir. Variable and independent variable. And you also give me many examples like dependency when petrol use more. Okay. So when electricity, the consumption of electricity increases, the bill also increases, and the bill depends on consumption of electricity. Bill depends on consumption of electricity. Dion, mute your audio. Dion. Bill depends on consumption of electricity. So here, bill depends. So which means electricity bill is an independent variable and consumption of electricity is independent. One variable is depending on the other. Bill depends on consumption of electricity. So bill is dependent and consumption of electricity is independent. Similarly, C equal to negative 2.24T plus 105. Okay, so here which is the dependent variable and which is the independent variable? Here the variables are time and temperature. Time and temperature, which one will be dependent and which one will be independent?
This will be independent. Huh?
Time and temperature, which is independent, which is dependent? Think, all of you think.
Time is independent.
Very good, very good. Time is independent. We cannot control time. It will go as it wish. We cannot control. As time goes, the temperature will slow down. Either if it is boiling, it will increase. If it is cooling, it will decrease. So time is independent and temperature is dependent. So that is the answer. Independent variable is time. Dependent variable is temperature. C. Independent variable is independent variable is time, T, and dependent variable is C. Dependent variable is C. Now, shall we move to the second one? What is the boiling temperature of the liquid? From that table, what is the boiling temperature?
105.
After boiling, we start cooling. So, 105. 105 is the boiling temperature. 105 is the boiling temperature. Second one, second question. If the liquid freezes at 26.6 degrees Celsius, the liquid freezes at 26.6 degrees Celsius, then at what time will it freeze? Assuming Rina starts the experiment at 10 a.m. She starts the experiment at 10 a.m. What is the experiment? After boiling, the liquid allows to freeze. Okay, and at 26.6 degrees Celsius, it freezes. 26.6 degrees Celsius, it freezes. So we need to find how, at what time it will freeze. And we have the equation C equal to negative 2.24 t plus 105. Okay. And given that C equal to 26.6. This is the temperature of freezing. And how much time it will take? So we need to find T. T we need to find. So in this given equation, using this equation, C is given 26.6. We need to find T. How can we find? That is, C is 26.6 equal to negative 2.24 into T plus 105. All of you try to get that T. It is a linear equation in one variable. You have studied linear equation in one variable. How can we solve it? How we will find that T? Try to get the T. 26.6 equal to negative 2.24 into T plus 105. So negative 2.24 we can take to this side. 2.24 T equal to 105 minus 26.6. How much it is? 105.6. 105 my equal to 105 minus 26.6 is equal to what? And Leah?
78.4.
So T equal to 78.4 divided by 2.24. T equal to 78.4 divided by 2.24.
And 35.
So it is T equal to 35 minutes. T equal to 35 minutes. For freezing, it takes 35 minutes. And she starts the cooling at 10 o'clock. So when it will freeze? 10 o'clock? 10:35. So the liquid freezes at 10:35 a.m. 10 plus 35 minutes. So it is 10:35 a.m. The liquid freezes at 10:35 a.m. See this, you can read this note. The dependent variable is the one that is restricted. In simple words, it is what you observe or measure to figure out what is happening. When you change your dependent variable and independent variable, the relation is when we change the independent variable, automatically the dependent variable will change. Dependent variable depends on the other one. Independent variable.
So, can you explain again the 9.3?
See, the liquid freezes at 26.6 degrees Celsius. Given that at the temperature 26.6 degree, it will freeze. Okay. So, we have an equation. Given that the temperature and time temperature and time are expressed, temperature and time is expressed using this given equation C equal to negative 2.24 T plus 105. So in this temperature is given. Temperature is 26.6. At a temperature of 26.6, the liquid freezes. We need to find the time. Okay, dependent variable. I explained. Dependent variable means it as time changes, as time changes, the temperature also changes. So as time moves, that liquid freezes. So at 26.6, the liquid freezes. And we need to find what is the time at that moment. So C is given. C equal to -2.24 T + 105. C is given, 26.6. We need to find T. So -2.24 × T + 105. Now it is a linear equation in one variable. The variable is T. So by taking -2.24 to the left side and 26.6 to the right side, we can solve it. 78.4. T is 35 minutes. And it is given that the girl starts her experiment at 10 a.m. So after 35 minutes, it will freeze. Okay. So what was the time then? It is 10:35. Understood, Midun?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, for next question, we need graph.
Yeah. What?
Ma'am, should we take the graph book for next questions?
No. No need. I will give a homework on this pie chart. You can draw on your note. Not now. Do it as homework. Okay. Ma'am. Now, shall we move to the next unit?
Ma'am.
Actually, these are the application level of what you have studied. A little bit challenging questions. You are applying to your normal life and your other subject also. This boiling, everything is on physics or chemistry. So there we are applying our linear equation and solving it. Understood? That is the integration. Okay. Integration of subjects. Now, next question. One second. A bar graph is a graph. Anybody read it?
Ma'am.
A bar graph.
Display of data using bars of different lengths.
One person.
For example, ICY Treats Ice Cream Company conducted a telephonic survey to find out favorite ice cream flavors of 200 students. The data so obtained is represented using a bar graph as shown below.
See, an ice cream company, IC Treats. Conducted a telephonic survey and they asked which flavor do you like and how many students they conducted survey on 200 students. Okay. And they got data like this: butterscotch 45, vanilla 15, strawberry 30, chocolate 35, mango 55 and orange 30. Which one do you like, Dion? Which? And your favorite is beyond
Spanish delight.
Spanish delight is there. Is it there? Spanish delight is there. It's not there. It is not there. Beyond.
In that we should say.
That butterscotch, vanilla, strawberry, chocolate, mango, orange. Which one do you like?
Ma'am, chocolate.
Chocolate. Shangari.
Vanilla.
And Leah?
I'm vanilla.
Vanilla. Michelle?
I'm butterscotch.
Butterscotch. And Abhishek, your favorite is?
I'm chocolate.
Chocolate. And Prarthana?
I'm vanilla.
Vanilla. Shivanya?
I'm butterscotch.
Butterscotch. Alina?
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Gobi?
I'm butterscotch.
Butterscotch. Mithun?
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Okay, others are switch off in their videos. And mine is butterscotch. Okay, so shall we move to the next? Next question. So these are the data that company got. And this total will be how much? 200 because they conducted survey on 200 students. 200. Okay. And after that, they draw a what is this graph?
They draw a bar graph.
And here represents a pie chart, and I am asking you to draw a pie chart based on this, not now, as a homework, okay? Because you know how to draw a pie chart. So do this as homework, this data, okay?
So for next class?
Next class, for the next class.
And a note.
The note, the note, backside. You just write a math, no need to take some other file. You attach along with your class note. You just give a heading. Give a heading, math magic questions. Then do that one. Okay.
No, no, I am writing in a paper in that.
That you can do. Okay. Now, next one. Let us study a bar graph and pie chart given below and solve some questions. What is the information given? The information given is the export from
Zedland,
a country that uses Zeds as its currency. Their currency is Zeds, like our rupee. Their currency is Zeds. And they are exporting some products. Their products, they are exporting. And what are the exporting items? Cotton fabric. Wool, tobacco, fruit juice, rice, tea, wheat, and some other things also they are exporting. And here shows a bar graph, which shows the exporting ratio. How much things they are exporting in some years, 96, 97, 98, 99, and 200. The percentage, the millions, not percentage, millions of sets. 20.4 means it is 20.4 sets. Million sets. 25.4 million sets. And 2000, the exporting is on 42.6 million sets. Okay, this is given. And we have some questions. First question, what was the total export in millions of sets from Zedland in the year 1998? 27.1 million sets. And what were the value of fruit juice exported from Zedland to 2000? All of you read that question. What were the value of fruit juice exported from Zedland in 2000? 2000, what is the total
42.6.
How much it is? One second. It is 42.6. Okay. Total it is 42.6. And on this 42.6, how much is fruit juice?
9%.
That you can see in the pie chart.
Yes, ma'am.
The pie chart. So 9% we are 9% is they are exporting fruit juice. They are using for fruit juice. So it's 9%. So 9 divided by 100. Find out how much it is. And see here, options are there. Find out which was the correct option. 3.8 million sets. So D is the correct answer. In the year 2000, the total income on exporting is 42 million sets. It's 9% is from 9% is from fruit juice. So 9 by 100. So 3.8 million sets. Now here some facts are given. In our NCERT books also they in between inside each chapter they will give some interesting facts. We can read, very interesting and very informative also. William Playfair, the businessman, engineer, economic writer from Scotland, created first known pie chart in 1801. So William Playfair, this is his name. He is the person who introduced pie chart, very useful thing in statistics. Very useful pie chart, bar graph, and histogram also. All these graphs are very useful in statistics. Okay, and Playfair wrote that making an appeal to the eye. See, when we are seeing a pie chart, it will be very very interesting to see because it is colorful. At a glance, we will get an idea about what was the data on discussion, isn't it? No. About if it is about election or about cricket or about football, we can easily understand, and it will be it is a pleasant feeling when we are seeing a pie chart because it is a colorful chart. So making an appeal to the eye when the proportion and magnitude are concerned. If it is mathematically performed, proportion and everything will be not interesting. But when we presented the same data with the use of a pie chart, it will be very interesting and making an appeal to the eye. And is the best and readiest method of conveying a distinct idea. So cool. Okay. So it is very easy to represent and very easily understandable by a common man by seeing a pie chart. So William Playfair is the man who introduced this pie chart. Now, shall we move to the next unit? Card game.
Yes, ma'am.
Card game. Three rectangular cards are numbered 1, 3, 5. Three rectangular cards are numbered 1, 3, 5. Sanjay picks one of these cards at random. Without looking those cards, he took one card. And what was the question? Find the probability that the number on the card he picks is?
5.
5. No.
1 by 3.
He picks the card 5. What is the probability? There are total 3 cards. Taking one. So what is the probability?
One by three.
The probability is 1 by 3. An even number card.
Zero.
What is the probability? Zero. There is no even number. So it is 0. An even number card is 0. Now he has 3 more cards. They are circular. He has 3 more cards. They are circular in shape. 3 circular cards are numbered 2, 3, 4. First rectangular cards, now circular cards. Rectangular cards are 1, 3, 5. Circular cards are 2, 3, 4. Sandra randomly picks one of the circular cards. Find the probability that the number on the card which she takes out is an even number.
2 by 3,
because there are two chances for even number. So it is 2 by 3. Total 3 cards. She has a chance of taking 2 cards. 2 by 3. Next question.
Okay, can I explain that one?
Yes. 11.1. 3 cards are there. From that, what is the probability of getting 5? How many 5s are there?
One.
So 1 divided by total number of cards? 3. 1 by 3. And second question is getting an even card. Is there any even number?
No.
So it is 0. Impossible event. We have studied about impossible event, isn't it? Isn't it? Do you remember that impossible events? If the
guys that one.
Now the circular cards. Circular cards, probability of getting an even number. Even numbers are 2 and 4. So it is 2 by 3. Now, next question. Amrita has all 6 cards. Amrita took all the 6 cards. Which are the 6 cards? 3 rectangular cards and 3 circular cards. The number on the rectangular cards are 1, 3, 5, and circular cards are 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. And what she's doing, she picks one rectangular card and one circular card. From this 6, she's taking one rectangle. Somebody's audio is
from you, I think.
Someone's audio is not muted. Okay, Alina, mute your audio. One circular, she's taking one rectangular card and one circular card, and she adds together the numbers. From one rectangular card and from circular card she took, and she's adding the numbers on the cards. Find the total of these 2 cards. Complete the table to show all possible totals. 3 totals have been done for you. So see, these are the rectangular cards. Rectangular cards, 1, 3, 5. And she has 3 circular cards, 2, 3, 4. Suppose if she took 2 and 1.
3.
The sum is?
3.
If she took 2 and 3, the sum is?
5.
Likewise, you complete that table.
Now, can you say again?
2, 1, 1, 3.
Amrita is taking one circular card and one rectangular card. Suppose if it is 2 and 1, the sum will be 2 plus 1. So first one is 3. She can also take 2 and 3, circular 2 and rectangular 3. So she will get a sum 5. What about the next one? Sum can be?
7.
2 and 5.
7.
Circular 2, 7. Similarly,
4 plus 1, 4, 4, 6, 8, 8 is 7, 5, 4 plus 3, 7, 7, and 9.
Only this much. Simple it is. Now, next question. Find out the probability that the sum of numbers on the cards that Amrita picks up is 8. How many 8s she will get when we...
Only one 8.
And how many totals are the total probability? How many total sums are there? Chances, total chances are... How many are there? Total chances?
6.
Is it 6? Only 6 sums?
Nine.
There are 9 sums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So from those 9 sums, what is the probability of getting 8? Only one chance for getting 8. That is 3 and 5. So 1 divided by total number of chances, 9. Okay. And anybody read this? What are the odds? Read, very interesting thing.
Croatian man named Franz Cilek, born in 1929, escaped death 7 times in several accidents, car, bus, flight. Later, he won a lottery worth US dollars
How much it is? 1 lakh.
1 lakh 11,000 dollars
US dollars
in 2003.
These
are the reasons why journalists label him the world's luckiest man.
Okay, he become the world's luckiest man because after many accidents he escaped, and along with she won a lottery also. So that person is considered as the luckiest person in the world. Next one. What is this odometer? What is the odometer?
I'm in the bike and the
car. Bike and cars, bike, we can see odometer, which shows how much kilometers and kilometers we have the car or the bike, the vehicle has been covered during the time period. Okay, so that is the odometer. So the odometer, here we have odometer and trip odometer. Trip odometer means when we start we can adjust that trip odometer. Trip odometer, what we will do when we start a trip, we will we can adjust to some particular number. From that we can calculate only for that trip how much we covered. That is a trip odometer. The usual odometer, it will shows from the starting of its that bike, that vehicle, how much kilometers it covered. Understood what is the difference between odometer and a trip odometer? Okay, the odometer of a car tells you how far the car has traveled in its entire life. That is the odometer, how far the car or the vehicle traveled from the beginning of it, the first day of the car. And the trip odometer can be reset, that we can adjust the time, reset at any time if you wish to find the length of the trip. If we are starting a trip, we will adjust to zero or some other number. From that we can calculate how much length distance we have covered. That is the trip odometer. So last year Mehta family Mehta family traveled for a vacation to Shimla in her brand new car. After a while, Mr. Mehta noted that the main odometer of their car read, main odometer, that is the odometer of the car, reads 490 kilometer and the trip odometer was showing 22. The main odometer or the odometer of the car shows 490, which means from the beginning of that car, it already covers 490 kilometer. And he adjusted that trip after some time only, he looked at a trip odometer. So after 22 kilometer, he looked at trip odometer. So at that time, its meter reading is 22 kilometer. Okay. Now when Mehta family reached the destination, Mr. Mehta asked his daughter Ishita, the main odometer is showing precisely 2 times the trip odometer. How much have we traveled today? That is his question to his daughter. Ishida started doing that. Ishida made the following observation table to analyze the progress of the journey. Okay, children, we have one more period. No, that period we will discuss that.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, children, bye. We will discuss it during the next period. Okay, bye. Bye, all of you. Bye.